For the second time this month, someone drove their vehicle into the Honokohau Small Boat Harbor on the Big Island. Bryce Moore has a story.
Ronald's Jordan returned to the Honokohau Small Boat Harbor around 8:30 last night, as he usually does after one of his manta ray dives.
When I was approaching to our slip, all of a sudden there was a cop and fire department, all the, you know, light was going off and start yelling at us, "There's a car in the water." Oh my gosh, I'm like, not again.
It's the second time a vehicle has driven into the harbor. The first was on April 29th. Kailua Kona resident Christy Hutchinson was there and can't believe it happened again.
Almost disbelief, I guess, and just thinking, what is wrong with these people in a way, but I guess they're going to have to do something about that harbor. And you know, it is almost validating for the first incident in a way, because the first woman had indicated that it was a GPS issue.
According to police, the driver said last night that GPS led her to take the route that she did, which was into the water.
Middle of the water, it's a nice slope, and there's a boat in front of you. Like, why would people go in there, you know?
If the weather is bad, I can see how you can mistake the gradient, perhaps, where it's difficult to see where the water starts and the ramp ends in bad weather, where maybe the reflection just doesn't hit right.
Hutchinson even tried to recreate the GPS route to pinpoint the issue.
Seeing if we could get it to lead us down that ramp, and we couldn't figure out maybe what would have happened where the GPS would lead you in or near around that ramp, but maybe there's something that can be done there, seeing as it does seem to be GPS related.
The harbor is a Department of Land and Natural Resources facility. They said this most recent incident wasn't reported, so they don't have specifics, but added the ramp is surrounded on all sides by boats, and there's no way most people would view it as anything other than a boat ramp. Bryce Moore, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.